Hey guys, it is Austin. What up? It's me. Can't you see me? Do you guys see me? Am I John Cena? Can't you not see me, guys? I am reacting to a request reaction from my amigo, my compadre, Alpha Omega. A lot of you have heard me say his name a lot because this man has watched every single one of my videos for over a year. And you know who's done that? Nobody but him. He has supported me from day freaking one. And he wants me to react to Hammer to Fall, guys, by Queen. I was actually shocked I have never heard this Queen song, because I've heard so many freaking Queen songs in my lifetime. I decided, you know what, let me look up a little bit about this song. And it says here that this song is a 1984 song by Queen and is the 8th track on the band's 11th album, guys, The Works. And it was the 4th and final single released from the album, and it was released in the UK on September a concert favorite. The song charted in Australia, UK, and in South Africa. Very interesting. This song was performed by Queen at Live Aid in 1985 and was featured in The Works Tour and The Magic Tour. And that's exactly what I'm watching, guys. I am watching the Queen Live Aid. Can't you imagine Freddie Mercury at a concert called Live Aid? And it's like, oh god, that was inappropriate. I'm sorry, guys. But to me, I don't know. Oh gosh, what am I trying to say here? What am I burying myself in a grave right now? Hold on, I need to get to my playlist here, y'all. I enjoy Queen a lot, guys. I love Queen, and I love everything Queen. And I think Freddie Mercury is hot and sexy and, beautiful. I mean, sexy, hot. He's hot. Anyways, guys, I'm going to get into this reaction because that's what I do, baby. Oh, my God. My computer is so freaking slow right now. It's embarrassing. I am so embarrassed, guys. I don't know why I did that. Oh, gosh. This is bad. This is bad. Hold on, let me just shake it off, baby. Hold on, I need to get ready here. I need to get ready. Before the video starts, guys, I am trying to get donations to help me and my brother out. If anyone could if anyone wants to help me out, whatever. If not, it's cool. But I'm gonna get into this song, guys. 3, 2, 1. Man, he can work that mic stand like no other. killing it. Get it. Dude, that mic's down though. I gotta love this guy, man. He has the best performance. One more time for what? Waiting for the hammer to fall. Oh, he's jerking off the mic, dude. I'm so jealous of that mic. Give it to me one more time! Dude, I actually read somewhere that Freddie Mercury was like some kind of like sex freak or something, dude. He enjoyed like orgies or some shit like that. Not sure how true that is, but I could see it. I could definitely see it. And it's like, why didn't you invite me, bro? No, I'm kidding, guys. I really like his performance skills. He really knows how to take control of the room and just kind of like just take everyone's attention onto him. Can you imagine like 50, 60,000 people and all of their eyes are just on you? That's a dream. That's a dream of mine, dude. Wow, he is definitely living his best life when he was alive. He is an amazing performer. That's what I really got to say. The way he moves around with that mic stand is almost like a part of his performance. It's not even a regular mic stand. It doesn't even like connect to a stand. It's just like one big pole that he carries around. I don't know why, but he kills it with that little mic stand he got going on. And he was sweaty like a motherfucker, dude. He was working his ass off during that performance. What a like powerful song though. The hammer's a fall. Yeah, and you know what? For a Queen song, it had a really awesome rock vibe to it. Usually when you see Queen, for me, it's almost kind of like a commercial rock, but this was more like, hey, we are a rock band and we can do rock sounds and we can do rock music. And that's really what it was like. It was like, hey, we're rock stars too, baby. But yeah, this was a wonderful performance. It was very entertaining. That stuff in the beginning, the hey oh hey oh, it was amazing to see how much people in the crowd actually took a part of that. So that means a lot of people have a lot of respect and admiration, I don't know the right word, for the band. That means they just love the band so much, which is easy to love. It's easy to fall in love with the band Queen. You know, the whole Freddie Mercury, the whole vibe of the band, it's almost like you're watching. It was almost like they were a legendary band even before Freddie Mercury died. They were a legendary band when they were still making music. And to me, that's kind of hard to do. Like Michael Jackson, he was already a legendary singer and he was still putting out music and all that. That's what Queen is like to me. They are a legendary band. Same with the Beatles. You know, Queen, the Beatles, fucking Michael Jackson. Those guys are Led Zeppelin. Even Def Leppard, you know, these guys are at the top of their game. I'm so jealous of being born in the 80s. Imagine, like, listening to this stuff just, like, for the first time. It's like, oh my god, I've never even heard this before. Imagine, like, the chills and just the feelings that go over your body. Tell me about that, guys. What was it like the first time you heard Queen Bohemian Rhapsody? Did it blow your mind? Were you like, what? Huh? Crazy. Yeah, that's what I, when I first heard Bohemian Rhapsody, I was like, this is insane. This is the best thing I've ever heard in my life. I listened to it probably like 5 times in a row. It was awesome. But guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Like I said in the beginning, if anyone wants to help donate, then pay my PayPal down below. That'd be cool. But besides that, like the video to help it grow. Subscribe. Peace out.